Hey there, friends. Thanks for checking in. I'm very disturbed with some of the things that I'm seeing with the ATF and some of the infringements that are coming down the pipeline. I truly believe this. They developed a document, or they call it a draft, that has pistol braces in their line of sight. And they're going to make a determination whether they fall under the NFA, where we would have to consider it a short-barreled rifle or short-barreled firearm. And that includes registration, which I believe is the ultimate goal. But if you read the draft, you see that it is very vague. It doesn't give any detailed information other than they're going to take a look at it. Now, we know that pistol stabilizing braces have been legal for years. There was a time when we weren't sure if it was legal to shoulder, and information came back saying, yes, there is nothing there that says that you cannot shoulder a stabilizing brace. And so it was fine. Like, it was fine. People spent thousands of dollars in purchasing these. We love them. But this document was very vague. They said, we're going to look at the size of the firearm, the function of the brace, the caliber of the firearm. Does it have an optic? Does it have a bipod? Does it have a foregrip? You know, what else does it have? Maybe they don't like it if it's Cerakoted. I don't know. But that's how vague it was. So we take a look at this right here. This is chambered in 5.7 by 28 millimeter, but it has a stabilizing brace that folds in. Is that going to be a problem? Nobody knows. Definitely infringements are coming our way. We see where they're going. We see where they've been. We see that any determination that they make supersedes any previous determination. And that was stated too. They also stated that most people who own these use them in good faith. Well, that's me and that's you. But it seems to me that by the stroke of a pen, they can make us criminals overnight. Because somebody out there may misuse a product does not make us criminals, but that's how we will be viewed. The size of the firearm was stated. So this one here, also 5.7 by 28 millimeter, has a 5-inch barrel. Is that going to be a problem? Or do they prefer a longer one? Or do they prefer a shorter one? Is it going to be a problem that this brace expands out? Nobody knows. They're going to re-evaluate it and make a determination. And although they say, as it sits right now, there's not going to be a ban, but all this is leading to a goal that they have had all along, and that is registration. They want to know who has what. And if they determine that it falls under the National Firearms Act, that means that we would be forced to be legal to register them. And although they say they would waive the $200 fee, like doing us a big favor, that we would be forced to register them. Now, imagine if you live in a state that has red flag laws. They would know exactly what you have, which is an infringement in the Second Amendment. You know, the Second Amendment doesn't state that, you know, that we will decide whether you have it or not and what's legal or not. That is so wrong on so many levels, but we see this happening, and we see it under the Trump administration, which is also very disturbing. But is this a little foresight into the Biden administration? I believe so. Biden got in there and said he's going to, well, we'll see what happens there, but I'm going to unite everybody together with the exception of gun owners. Now, that wasn't said, but that's how I took it. The uniter is going to unite, except for if you're a gun owner, we're coming after you. And that was also stated. One of the first things they want to do is a pistol brace going to be on the docket? Absolutely, 100%. We have thousands of dollars into these. We love them. We enjoy them. And it seems that we could be criminals overnight with a very vague and not easy to understand document. So last time they pulled this, or they've been pulling this all along, but a while back they said that certain types of rifle ammo could not be used, or considering banning that, making it illegal to own the rifle. They said it pierces through body armor and therefore law enforcement is in danger. And they opened up comments to the citizens, and they did that for about a month. And there were so many comments that it overwhelmed the system. And the acting ATF director at the time threw his hands in the air and said, I quit this job. It was under Obama. I quit. I'm not going to change anything. And we viewed it as a victory. Now, that is standing together for the Second Amendment. It seems as if we're going to have to do that again. And the way I read it is that it's going to be scaled down for a two-week period that falls right around Christmas, where everybody is celebrating and getting together and having meals and exchanging gifts and everything else. They're preoccupied, and that is very cleverly timed by them. But nonetheless, we are going to have a call to action to respond to this. Now, I believe once that's open, they're going to ask for your address and everything else. Once, you know, you don't see this in other areas of life, but when it comes to firearms, it seems to be a high priority that they know everything about us and what we have. But I'm certainly going to write my letter, and I think we should overwhelm the system once again. Pistol stabilizing braces, a legal device, now may be illegal, and they may force to register depending on what they determine with their very vague document that they submitted. We're going to have to stand together on this one, and we'll see how this whole thing turns out. I appreciate you watching, and you guys be safe.